Hey guys, what's going on? It's Nock, welcome along. We're back with Infinifactory again. Part 23. As we take on Skip Drive Part 3. What's going on, Flame Tusk? You got Reg Mage to 70 trying to decide what to level next. Man, that game just seems to go on and on and on. It'd be nice to get back to some Final Fantasy myself, but we've been kind of consumed by Infinifactory and our need to kind of get this done. So, last night when we finished off, we was remodeling this section around here. So wasn't happy with the way it was working. Okay. So. Let's see what we can come up with tonight. I just kind of want to get this like base finished more than anything. Okay, so conveyor's going to be here. Don't know what it's going to be suspended to, mind you. Maybe we can do this. So my idea here is I want to rotate this a few times. But that there is actually going to prevent the rotation. Mate, I have been through so many different ideas and concepts for this. And this is just what I'd stuck with last night. Your normal raid queue popped. Not sure I know what you mean. Why did I think that was the right place to do that? Okay, so then this is going to feed this in now from, I guess, from the side. And that's going to end up there, isn't it? So I guess my next one let's come on over. Okay, so then I'm gonna want this welding set up again. Now you see that's gonna be problematic because it's coming in from the side. I kind of think I'm best off to try and keep it. Alright, you know what? Let's just do this a minute. To kind of get this in the right position. Which is not there. So how would you tackle it then, Flame Tusk? Surprised that I'm not put the sides on. But, alright, so I left off last night thinking this was the right thing to do, and I'm now not so sure. Had all this working though last night in one of my other solutions, which I've since deleted. Okay. So I need to come in here.
but the welder's the issue for me now because I've got this here. I'm wondering though, if I built the outer bit, then I would only need one weld on the bottom, wouldn't I? If I had like this joined with all the cross sections as well, I would effectively need to weld those two pieces together there to join the bottom to it. But then that's not necessarily an easy feat, is it? So you did the bottom bit as the last weld. Okay. Let's forget everything we just did. Everything we thought we knew last night. So, let's... That's not going to do anything, is it? Why do they double up? Oh, it's because of this, isn't it? I don't necessarily need to bring it down that low. Okay. Get rid of that. Okay, these are going to come over here. Now, I don't think if I do this, I'm going to scrap all this as well, this sorting mechanism here. So, effectively, I want to join A to B here. Okay, so they're massively in front. One thing I need to check though is... yeah, that will work. Okay. So, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2. They want to be on this level. So, I want something like this. Oh, I'm one high. One too high and one too... I need to go one further back. Okay, gotcha. Alright, it's going to be something like this. That's still not right. What did I do wrong this time? Alright, still wants to be another one back. Okay. What am I doing? I just want to be back, I want to be forward. What a dummy. Sorry, that's going to want to be too forward then. Okay, so Comes to a rest here. One, two, three. Oh, that's not gonna work, is it? Jeez. This one can be a conveyor to send them over here. Okay. So that's joining those bits up. So I guess now I'm going to want to sort them in some way, shape, or form. They are all being individually welded, aren't they? Okay. So here, I need to stop them from falling off. I don't know what I can do about them falling off here, though. Yeah, I'm losing. I'm not really sure how I'm losing. Because of this. Okay, so I can ease. I should be able to alleviate that actually by doing this. because it's hanging about waiting for that to move. Okay, I didn't lose any blocks that time, but there were still some that were like coming ahead. Okay, so we have this set up. So I'm thinking, okay, so bring it one forward. Bring it one forward. Here. Okay. So this is where like rotations and things need to start happening. So let's position them all in place. Now we work out what we want to do. Bring across. Rotate. And push it back. So to do that, I'm going to want to do this, that. This one is going to go to here. It's then going to be rotated. And then I'm going to push it back to here. I hope. Okay, so then, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, conveyor, flipped, and can connect to there. Okay, maybe that wants to stay where it was then. Maybe. Hold on, I need to... So I need another one there. Then that should be in the right place. Fingers crossed. Okay. So, I want to weld this piece together. I think probably at the same time, I should bring these other two further away. Bring them further out. Okay, so that's going to be one, two. Okay, so it needs to be one more across. Welder there, welder there. Gotcha. One higher. Okay. So, that's going to do that now. That might get in the way now, actually. We'll see. Okay, bravo. Excellent. So then, when it hits here, if I have another upwards one here, trying to think which is going to be the best. If I rotate this whole thing again, I think if I rotate this whole thing again, one, two, three, and one across. Alright, let's see what this does. I can get it to do this. Sorry, I'm trying to speak and concentrate at the same time, and my brain's not coping with it at the minute. Okay. So then here, I want to join up this next one. So it's come two more out with this. So let's assume this will get past that block in the middle. Which it does. Still needs to come a bit further forward though. That's alright, okay. So it rotates. One more, and then one, two, three. So one more. I want to come one more across. That one needs to come three more across. Excellent. Okay. So that will give me three. So one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. That's just a rough guess. So one across, and one further in. So okay. So that is in position. Now, I think the best thing to do now would be to drop this down. With this one, while that's all like working around here, I can get this one into position. So let's think about how we could drop this down. It's gonna be, let's try this. It's going to drop down, but we can compensate with this. Just think 1, 2, 3, drop down there. Okay. Just need it to drop down. That's really all I need it to do at this point. Come on. Just let me get through, man. Jeez. Okay. We got there. So, are we going to catch it here? perfect. So, it's going to be a 1. It should land on here. We have 1, 2, 3. So, next thing we need to do is this. So, let's get rid of all this. And let's start thinking about the pathing. And we're going to want to do a single rotation at some point. Next one across. Actually, you don't need that because it's going to be suspended by the other end, isn't it? So, what's going on with it now? Okay. So, what I'm going to do here is preempt this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So, yeah, 2 more. Would you look at that, ladies and gentlemen? So, that should build us our outside frame. Huzzah! Okay. So, that is the middle. Alright, so I don't know now where we're gonna go. So we've done that. That's going to get stuck on there. Believe in yourself, Flame Tusk. Believe in yourself. I feel like I've got to lift up. Yeah, so we've got a big problem now. Big problem. Unless I go back the other way. So if I went to like there, Whoopsie. Okay, so what if I shortened this? Brought this over here. Just thinking, if I do this, then I've got more room then to play over here and send it backwards. How am I getting this so wrong? I don't understand. I made like one small change and now I'm like completely missing the conveyors. Okay, so now we weld. Thank you. Now we weld. Now we weld in the right place. Excellent. Excellent. Okay. So, now we need to extract this. Lovely. No! Tombries, get away. Evil things. Evil, evil things. Morph them into ribbons, though. It's probably about their only use, good use on Final Fantasy VII. You can morph them into ribbons. Okay, so the outer core is being built successfully. We've not got no issues with that, which is good. We had more than 10 created there as well. So that is all running tickety-boo. So, what does that leave us with? Okay. Thank you. So if we drop this to as far as here. That's going to sit there.
Okay.
So, this is where I need to work out the delays. Also, okay, then, actually let's bring this out one further than this. Can I ask a question, Flame Tusk? When you did your, did you weld the top bit onto the pillar? Or did you just weld that onto the top? Oh, I suppose it's got to be joined though, hasn't it? Yeah, it's got to be... The top bit will have to be welded, won't it? Ignore that. That's a bit of a dumb question. What? That's the thing I was having trouble on the first time I actually streamed. Put the bottom on first, yeah. Yes, that's what I'm trying to kind of set up here. So I'm just going to like position it here and then time the drops. That is what I'm going for. That's not right. That is though. Okay, so we have this. Now we have this stupid. This is the thing that I was really, really struggling with previously. Because it's a bit of a funny world, this one. So, do you know what? I suppose you got a point, because if I lift it up, it's going to stay on top, isn't it? Of course. Yeah, no, that makes perfect sense. So, that's the end bit, isn't it? Okay. So, okay, gotta think about this now. If I lift it up, gotta slide the welder in, haven't I? So the welder's gotta come in from this side and it's gotta slide into here. Okay. Just putting that there just as a marker. Thank you. Okay. So it's going to go 1, 2, 3. That's going to be that. Then I'm going to want where do I want my sensor? This is like a much easier solution than what I was going for previously. Could I not just put it there? Like that. Have I got a big enough gap? Hold on. Ah, don't do that. That wants to be... Okay, yeah, I want an extra block there. Take out that one. Then this one wants to be here. Then, actually, then I do this. Okay, let's weld that together, but I need to release it. There we go. All right. Thank you. But I create five of them. I create five of them to a single outer core. One, two, three, four, five. How can I can't delay these very well. I just need to think of a better storage solution. Okay. So, that's 8. So that's going to go into there. Sorry, I'm going quiet. Going very, very quietly. Okay, so that's going to do that, that's going to do that. I'm in like proper try hard mode at the minute. But I need to make up. Getting quite excited at the prospect that I am almost done. It's gonna have to come over. It's gonna hit that though, so this setup isn't gonna work. Thank you. That's not going to work. Okay. Let's do this instead. Let's come in from behind. I think my inverted conveyor needs to go there. I'm just going to need to move a little bit more. Oh. Alright, that'll work. So, here. So it's going to push that onto there, and then push them all across. And that should hopefully stay out of the way of... should stay out of the way of the outer casing. Another conveyor there. Okay. That's all working fine and dandy. We're getting there, boys. We are getting there. I'm starting to get excited. If I don't finish this tonight, there is something seriously wrong. I don't want to give up tonight until I've got this put to bed. Ignore that one for now. Okay. So. Next thing we need to deal with. Is this. Okay, so how many have I already lost? I've already lost two. Okay, so I need to delay it a little bit more. So, I'm going to bring this out two more. Okay. I apologize again, guys, I'm not really speaking that much. But I am kind of like in deep concentration mode at the moment. Okay. That's in sync. That's in sync. So I now need to do one, two, three, four, One, two, three. Two, three, one, one, two, three, one on the top. Then might need one of them there. Get rid of this. Let's try this again. Needs to go higher. I think as well, this is going to need to come out. A bit earlier. Still wants to be higher. Let's run through that again. Oh. Oh, I reached the height for the thingy, didn't I? Okay. So if I reach the maximum height for the lifter, not necessarily here, but I can maybe lift up one of the sides. Just one more block. But if I got that there and that lifts that up there, I can move this one. Right. Maybe not here, but maybe in one of the other positions if this doesn't work. Something like this. Oh, yeah. That does that. It'll see that. It'll push it over. Should work. That should work. So yeah, once it's got that extra like bit, it gets right to the top, and then it pushes this extra one out. I may, however, need to do this just to stop it from being pushed across in case that like comes out early. Let's see. Just like that. Okay, so that worked perfectly. I gotta add this extra block in here. So, let's make a skip drive. Fingers crossed. Come on. We got this, I hope. Alright, so... the ending is still a bit of an enigma for me at the minute. Okay, so, move it all across this way. I think that's what I gotta do. I gotta shift it. We're close. We are close. This space over here, I'm doing nothing with it. So let's try and utilize some space, shall we? So, back, cross in the middle. One there. One there. And one there. Okay, so what I'm going to do is to play it safe. Let's just keep stacking these on the shelf for now. So it gets to here. And we need to do a weld here and a weld here. Now this needs to be on here and on here. So in effect what we're going to have is piston there. There. then. I gotta remember how to do this again now. I think I need to put a block in between though, don't I? I can test it. Yes, okay, so that's the position. That's the position, so that's gonna move. So I want a conduit here. Right, isn't it? I'm sure that's right. And then this is triggered by a sensor. So let's place our sensor just here. One too many. I think that worked though. Okay. So, that's created that. That's done that. So how do I now... Oh dear. Flame Tusk, any suggestions how I can get this out of here? Oh, hold on. Can I not do something like this? This could work. Boom. Boom, baby, boom. Right. Okay. Just need to work out the logistics of this part now. We are so tantalizingly close. That is timed almost to perfection. If I do say so myself. Okay. Now I just need to do that whole lifting thing. So, all right. Sorting out these last few teething problems. Okay. Oh boy. Excited now. Oh boy, I am getting excited. So it's two above this. Okay, so if we're too high here, what I want to do is I want to kind of restrict the height just to make things a little bit better. Okay, let's not worry about that. It's going to cause more issues than it's worth, it seems. Thank you. Almost there, boys. Do I need like a vertical conveyor? What's going on? Please, please, please don't be a dick now. Lifting up too early. Will this work? I know it's not going to lift at the minute, but it's more I've got enough clearance from there. Yeah, if you drop them in the Infinifactory channel, Flame Tusk, if you're talking about your Infinifactory puzzles, if you're talking about portal puzzles, I have my Google form that you can submit to. No, I have to. Come on. This isn't difficult. Why isn't that lifting now? Thank you. Where am I putting them though? Come on, I can't. No, no. Come on. Focus. We've got this far. Don't fail me now. Yeah, no, I'm just let me focus a minute. I think I know what needs to be done. I need to pause it really to see where I am. Do you know what? I could actually have my two welders here as well. So, I don't need these welders here. All right, so that's the edge. Let me plan this out. And I may be able to better visualize what I actually need to do. It's going to be there. All I don't need to go up. One, two, three. I may need to drop these down a little bit. Also, why have I still got these ones here? I don't need them. Ladies and gentlemen, it's taken almost 4 months, 58 hours, 23 streams, but finally, we have put and completed Infinifactory. We've done it, boys and girls. We have done it. Finally! Wow. Wow, wow, wow. Let's get rid of this one. Okay, so let's conclude the mission, finally.
Hey, Nia, what are you going to do when we get back?
I will see my family. I miss them.
I want to meet the president. Think that'll happen?
You're Canadian, right? I thought Canada had a prime minister.
We're going to be heroes. Who's ever said they wanted to meet the prime minister of Canada?
Ah, well, I'm sure we're all going to meet many presidents when we return.
Salvatross has given the signal. Awaiting your command, Dave.
Let's go home.
Punch it.
Oh, it's smaller than I thought it would be.
Welcome back to the Afternoon Slowdown. I'm your host, Levi Skinner. This has been one hell of a week, hasn't it, listeners?
It sure has.
First, an alien spaceship crashes into the sea. Then the human race meets its first real extraterrestrial. And then we learn that the missing million were actually abducted by a malicious spacefaring empire. We are no longer alone in the universe. I want to know what our listeners think. To the phones! Okay, first caller, what's your name?
Hey, it's Mickey. My fiance and I would have been married by now if those goddamn aliens hadn't...
Yeah, I see the passenger seat in my spacesuit.
I'm going to join the Marines, take some alien ass, and get it back. You hear me, you toad-faced bastards? We're coming for you.
Okay, you sound pumped. Next caller.
This is Phil from Arbutus, and I've got to say it. What a crock. Does the government seriously think we're going to fall for this? This is yet another ridiculous cover for those genetical engineering experiments they're doing. You know they've been trying to crossbreed a man and a pig for decades now.
Manitoba.
And they don't want anyone knowing about it. So
how you pronounce it, Manitoba?
Awful excuses.
Are you Canadian, Phantos?
Right, The government thinks they can get away with blaming the kidnapping...
Oh, wait a minute. No, it was the Prime Minister of Iceland.
Yeah, right.
In Canada. Yeah, but are you Canadian?
Let's talk to someone else. Who's this?
My name's Amanda, and I think we need to stay out of this. We haven't even put a man on Mars, and now we're going to start an intergalactic war? Sure, they took a million people, but what about the rest of us? The aliens could wipe us off the face of the planet easily. It's too big of a risk. Let's stay grounded.
Thanks, Amanda. You make a good point. All right, let's talk to someone else. Hello, you're on.
Hey, Levi. Mary here. Okay, so let me play the devil's advocate.
All right, you are coming.
Instead of uniting with the so-called resistance, we join up with the aliens that abducted all of the humans in the first place. Let me explain.
I was meant to actually go to Canada when I was 14. Unfortunately, the trip to Canada got cancelled. I got rearranged. We actually went to Switzerland instead. I was really looking forward to going to Canada.
Okay.
I'm just going to go sort of like in the south, around near the Rockies. Not the Rockies, around like Niagara Falls. Sorry. That's like Canadian-American border, isn't it? If my American geography is not very good.
So
I'm pretty sure that's where it is anyway.
This is Cheryl from Lake Placid. I've dreamt about this moment ever since I was a little girl. I mean, it's wonderful. We are not alone in the universe.
This road is a long-ass road, man.
I'm going to join up so I can meet these new beings. I want to know all about their history.
Anyway, let's talk about the game while this is going on. I have to say, I was massively, massively surprised by this game. I thought episodes and hours ago that I was pretty much done. And then we get thrown into the whole extra side, like the Resistance campaign.
Hello, Mr. Levi. Oh. I'm an avid listener of your show and greatly enjoy your informative recording.
Sorry, I'll carry on in a minute.
This is my first time calling in. I am actually the extraterrestrial you mentioned earlier, and I thought I could add my own perspective to this new situation.
Oh, please.
Also, would it be possible to get the phone number of your previous caller?
You had one job, Rhonda. Don't let crazy on the air. Well, we're out of time here on the afternoon slowdown. Tomorrow I'll be talking with Debbie Hauer, the infamous winner of the Humboldt County Chili Cook-Off. Be sure to tune in tomorrow and let us know what you think about ChiliGate.
Oh, I will, don't you worry.
This is Levi, reminding you to take it slow. Good night.
All right, so there we go. That is Infinifactory. Everything is got a big, nice tick on it. We have completed every single puzzle. All right, so here's what I was going to say. The game really, really surprised me. I thought when we was going through here, there was no hint of this Resistance campaign at all. And I kind of got through these thinking, yeah, we're getting through this. Got my hopes up. We'd almost finished the game. And then boom, the Resistance campaign comes in. But yeah, it was definitely a very challenging addition to the game. Very challenging indeed. I have to say, the puzzle difficulty towards the end really did ramp up. I don't think it was that the builds were difficult in themselves. I think I really struggled with the actual space that I was given. And it was kind of overwhelming, the amount of space that you actually had to do things in. And because of that space and because of the sheer size of the builds, you really had to think about how you position things to take up the space. I'm really looking forward to playing some custom puzzles from the workshop. I know Flame Tusk and Iron Smeltery both have some puzzles for me to do. So we will be doing one or two further streams on Infinifactory where we're going to take a look at some community maps. But I think once I've played a few, I will be putting this game to bed because, like I said, we have been playing this. We started this game on the 1st of August, almost 4 months ago. And let's say we are 58 hours into this. We have pretty much put everything else on the back burner for the last 2 weeks to get this done. And man, am I happy that we have got this done? It's very, very challenging game towards the end, but very, very rewarding that you can actually figure it all out. Well, guys, that is going to bring us to the end of the stream today. A fitting end to the end of the stream. Thank you very much, everybody, for tuning in. I appreciate the support, as always. Links on screen. We'll be back tomorrow night with, I don't know, maybe we'll get some Final Fantasy in tomorrow night. And if they are around my friends across the other side of the pond, we may have some co-op stream action with Worms or golf with your friends. So yeah, come around tomorrow, guys, at 9:30 p.m. GMT is when we start our Friday fun stream. But until then, I've been Nock, you've been awesome. Thank you for your support during Infinifactory. See ya.